This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious, the Leroy Fury cast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my. I say what the fuck I want, bitch.
Episode 80 of Leroy Fury cast. Yeah! I love nachos, but I hate nerds.
I despise nerds. It's so many garbage nerd properties out there. So many garbage nerd properties. But like, when it comes to the new House of the Fire-Breathing Geckos and Rings of Power, the racism is going crazy. Like, there's so many garbage properties out there. But since it's melanated people on screen having fun, being awesome, being quirky, not being eunuchs, not being slaves, not being drug dealers and whores, just being outstanding, good people, it's a problem. The nerds don't like it. No. The Negroes are supposed to be basketball players and drug dealers. They can't be hobbits.
Muggsy Bogues, Bud Webb, Earl Boykin, Kevin Hart, Lil Wayne, Lil Duval, Bushwick Bill, Tony Cox, Beetlejuice. We can't be short. We can't be dwarves and hobbits. Seriously? Shut the fudge up. I'm not cursing because it's the first 10 minutes. Wait a minute, I'm not monetized. Shut the fuck up. You fucking bozos. Mad as shit. You're in your basement all day in your little magical fantasy world. No black people exist. And when you see one, you yell nigga 100 times to try to boil them up inside and get them angry. Yet, Black Panther Wakanda Forever still coming out. There's still a Puerto Rican elf on Rings of Power. Still a melanated lady dwarf and a black male hobbit on Rings of Power. Reva, the third sister, Moses Ingram, is still alive in the Star Wars Galaxy universe. A galaxy is in the universe. She's still in the Star Wars universe. Nothing you can do about it. You losers. Shut up. Hey, dude. Shut up. In your basement all day tripping. Like a bunch of idiots.
No, I can't move. I don't like it.
This is my fantasy world. Where I get away from them. Now they're here. Where I like things.
No, no, no.
Dude, shut up. You sound stupid.
Hold on. My pillow's crazy.
Crazy, insane, insane, crazy. When I say Hussein, you say Shady. Did Eminem say that? I forgot. I'm not sure. I'm currently watching Cobra Kai Season 5. It's exciting. I like it. Spoiler alert, Stingray just came back in like episode 4 or 5. I like Paul Walter Hauser. Great actor. I watched Blackbird.
They yelled, Mommy, Mommy, when I put them in the ground.
Larry Hall's a piece of shit. He needs to stay in prison forever. I watched Blackbird. Shout out to Jimmy King. Good looking Italian drug dealer guy. Almost had to do 10 years, but he got a guy to confess to a murder.
Cool guy. Great series, too.
Bill Burr spoke on it on his podcast. And someone put up a side-by-side, like, documentary footage with Bill Burr talking about it on YouTube, and it's really cool. Check it out. Jimmy King, Larry Hall situation, Blackbird. Really cool.
Cobra Kai is good this season. Shout out to Kenny. Lil Kenny was the guy that got bullied on season 4. Learned how to fight. Beat LaPusso's ass. Got his revenge back, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, you know what I'm saying? That's what's up. This is episode 80, baby. 80 episodes in. Yeah. It would be cool if I could make like $5 every time I did this. Then I had like 400. 400. Keep it 400. Keep it 400. Keep it 400. It's probably bad math, but I don't care. I think 80 times 5 is 400. Well, what if I got $5 from every listener? Then I'd have more money. 400 plus more money. 400. Probably more money. Maybe even $10. 800 money. I like singing songs, bro. I just realized, like, I went on a walk last night. Didn't see Junkyard Dogs, but I did see Snakeskin. So I shedded Snakeskin. Saw a cool bird in the parking lot. I walked like 6 miles last night. The moon was extremely bright for some reason. The moon last night was brighter than normal. I don't know what happened, but it was brighter than normal. Probably something going on with like crystals and retrograde atmosphere, Mercury, Volvo, Buick, I don't know. Mitsubishi, I'm confused. I don't collect crystals. But I did spend time with a woman named Chrissy. Boy, oh boy, she was like a water fountain. She was melanated. She was a Moorish gal. She wasn't a bigot, she was a spigot. She sprayed me. I'm chilling right now. Haven't been to the movie since Beast came out. Idris Elba. The trailer for Beast is fire. And you can watch Beast now on digital. Produced by Will Packer. You know what I'm saying? I've been drinking out of the same bottle for months now. Many, many months. I think, was it September? When was the first roasting jokes? Up and Smoke? Randy Staples had a Up and Smoke thing where you could smoke weed and tell jokes or smoke weed and listen to comedians. I didn't attend the following one, but I went to the first one and I told my jokes. It was pretty cool. I still do not partake in marijuana. But everyone else was smoking. And the weed smelled like incense. That was nice. It didn't smell like a loud butthole. Some weed smelled like loud butthole. And that's weird. But yeah, if you're mad that there are black people in Lord of the Rings and Star Wars and Game of Thrones universe, and they have like powerful, upstanding positions in their roles, if you got a problem with that, stick your head out of your mother's cunt. Stop being a fucking prick. Be better than that. Be better than that. Try to be better than that. Fucking race. How you a nerd and you racist? You're a racist white nerd? Don't be all three. Pick two. Be a white nerd. Be a white racist. A racist white nerd? Ugh. You think real racist people are gonna let your nerdy comic book reading ass? You're not even a good nerd. You're a nerd for comic books and fictional pop culture. You're not even like a real racist. Like, you're a real racist, but like, you're not a helpful nerd. Like, if you're a racist white nerd, you're supposed to be making devices and chemicals. I'm gonna poison the black community. I'm gonna get rid of this ethnicity. The Filipinos, I had it up to the head with them. I don't like the Italians. I'm a racist white nerd. I'm gonna make a disease. I'm gonna poison the cannolis. If you speak Tagalog, I'm gonna put a chip in your neck. It turns your brain into applesauce. Like a real racist, like, nerd. Like a helpful racist nerd. You're not even helpful racist nerd. You're just racist motherfuckers that like Chewbacca. Newsflash, Chewbacca's fur is brown, bro. Whoop-de-doo-de-doo-de-doo. Newsflash. Remember, remember Mighty Morphin Power Rangers the movie? Oh no!
Uh oh, you're in trouble. Bubble.
Double bubble trouble. Uh oh, you're in trouble. That's M.I.A. I listen to Miss Pat on Ron Funches' podcast, Getting Better. She's always telling the truth, man. She told me the truth. And comedy, you gotta fuck with people that fuck with you. Don't be trying to get in other groups, trying to fit in with emo. Nah, you get in with people that fuck with you. And that's what you gotta do. You gotta get in with people that fuck with you. And that's what I'm doing right now. Shout out to Chris Harrison, Bernard, Philip Chang, Angel Penn, Mark Marlar, Adam Lax, Adam Conan, Johnny Quest, Jake Tibbs, Vinny Lombardi, Dude in the Corner, Peyton Warner, Sean Savoy, Will Thomas. Shout out to all of them. They be like, yo, come do a spot over here. We'll have you. We'd like to have you. Come to a spot here. Joey LaFaro. Comedy shows near me. Shout out to those good people, man. Everybody else, stay hydrated. It's all good. No beef, no hatred. I like Cat Williams more and more, too. Like, Cat Williams recently did an interview on the radio where he was talking about the state of comedy. He was like,
shout out to Kevin Hart. I shouldn't have said anything bad about Kevin because he's undoubtedly the king of comedy right now. The most famous, notoriable.
Now, did he say notoriable?
That's the most notable comedian right now. Shout out to Kevin Hart. I want to do a show at the Staples Center. It's already sold out. 19,000 seats, that's all. It's going to happen in 45 days. I want it to be me, Red Grant, Dave Chappelle, and Kevin Hart. It's going to close out the whole show. And of course, I, Cat Williams, is going to host it.
I was like, yo, Cat Williams really turned a new leaf. He really, like, he used to, like, say not so nice things about Kevin Hart. And Kevin would be like, yo, what's going on, man? Come on, Cat. Like, what are you doing? And you know, yeah, Cats are really happy right now. All this comedy controversy going on. Comedians dying. Comedians getting in trouble for old skits. Disgusting old skits. Old sketches. And shit. And here we got Cat Williams just sitting back chilling. People act like he was the most problematic comedian ever. Like, nah, he had some bad days. Some tumultuous times. These other motherfuckers like, ew. Cat Williams like, see,
I wasn't that bad.
I just got in fights every now and then. Which is true. I remember I saw one video of Cat Williams jumped off stage, hit a dude, and then jumped back on stage. In the other video, he went to that neighborhood to play soccer with the kids. Not football. Soccer. I'm an American.
But it's football. You bellend. Manchester United. Arsenal.
Shut up. Your jerseys look nice, though. Soccer jerseys look great. I'm going to buy a soccer jersey. I got to find a green team. I like green. I'm going to get an Ivory Coast team. I love gold. I love coast. You know what I'm saying? I was at the Red Lounge last night. Today's September 10th, 2022. It's 4:41 p.m. And I started doing this podcast almost 14 minutes ago. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold up. Hold up. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I've been doing this podcast for like 14 minutes so far, and it's 4:41 p.m. 2022, September 10th, Saturday. Sticky icky, ooh, ooh, ooh. Sticky icky, icky, ooh, ooh, ooh. But this is what happened. Last night, I went on a walk, right? I walked last night. I walked from one place to another, caught a bus. I walked like 6 miles last night, okay? I walked 6 miles. Dude, got in the house at like 2 in the morning. 2:10. Ate a big bowl of popcorn with like 2 bottles of water.
maybe even three. And I danced my ass off in my bedroom from like 2:30 to 6:30 a.m. I danced for like 4 hours straight, just listening to like all types of music and stuff. Beyonce, I was just going through Beyonce's catalog. Not the whole catalog, just like the stuff I like the short, quaint, brief essentials. I was just Single Ladies, dude. I was doing the dance to the Single Ladies step of the workout last night, doing the little, which is a great song. Single Ladies is a great song. I like Madison with a Y and two N's, but you don't know where the Y is. She was with Wong, kept calling them Wongers on She-Hulk, and she spoiled Sopranos twice. I was like, damn, good thing I actually watched the show, because she spoiled it for me, too. I would be upset, but I already watched the show. At least she ain't spoiled Sex in the City. I'm still watching that. I'm on season 3. Great writing, great show. I love Kim Cattrall so much. Samantha is such a whore. She's such a whore. Charlotte's a good girl. Samantha's a whore. Miranda, I'm glad she left Steve. Please don't take Steve back. Carrie, she just wrapped up in Big's hands. She needs to just stay with Aiden. Oh, season 3 is getting so good. I love Sex and the City. Such a good show. Yeah, man, my resilience no bounds. Went to bed at 7 a.m. Woke up at 12. So I got 5 hours of sleep with all of that dancing and stuff. Dancing. I'm a dancing machine. Oh, baby. All of that dancing and moving and physicality. And I was like, yo, this is crazy, son. It's crazy. My body knows no bounds. I bought a new pair of boots, hiking boots. I think that's why I had energy. I had hiking boots on the whole time. If you walk long amounts of miles with hiking boots on, you're going to do pretty good, man. I had to buy them off online, though. I had to buy them from Big Daddy Bezos, which is where I got this hat, which is where I got this camera I'm filming on. The tripod that I'm filming, I got it also from Big Daddy Bezos. The tablet sitting next to me is from Big Daddy Bezos. Yeah, man. Why am I calling him Big Daddy Bezos? Oh, yeah, because he's 5'7", which means he's a king. Same height as me. Hello, Jeff Bezos, my fellow 5'7" brother. Thank you for Rings of Power. It's not the best show, but it's something I can watch in my spare time. I even deleted a pornographic film off of my tablet so I could squeeze in space for episode 3 of Rings of Power. So I say, oh, thank you, Sir Bezos. Oh, thank you, Sir Bezos. Not my lord, Sir Bezos. I am Sir Leroy. You call me Sir Furious, please. Respectfully. Like I respectfully respect you for your decision to not share your wealth with any of these peasants. Don't. We all know people made fun of you for being short, funny looking, bald with a weird laugh. And you finally won the game of life and became a billionaire. Hundreds of billionaires. You might even beat Mansa Musa. Yes, Mansa Musa exists. Read a book. Shout out to Jeff Bezos, though, man. You doing your thing. All your products are good. I ordered the new phones. I can film myself doing comedy sets. Speaking of that, like, not only did I walk 6 miles, come in the house, and dance for 4 hours straight, before all of that, I did 18 minutes on stage. I did 18 minutes at Red Lounge. Receive increments. Okay, that's cool, too. I didn't know I was doing 18. I thought I was doing 15 to 10. I'm like, hold up, my set should be over by now. No one give me the light. These guys did not tell me I was doing 18 minutes, bro. You should have told me. I would have stopped way early. I was so low-key upset. But I got the stage time. I got it in. I held the crowd together for at least 16 of the minutes. At least 16. This woman sat next to me, kept talking. She was beautiful. She had Bantu knots. She looked like Ty Davis a little bit, but she wasn't Ty Davis because Ty Davis knows better because Ty Davis is a professional comedian. But this woman was just kept talking on her phone. I was like, oh my God, you're so beautiful. Why? Get up and walk downstairs if you're gonna talk. Go in the back if you're gonna talk. Don't talk while I'm on stage. I gotta hold these people's attention. I got weird jokes, son. That's what happened, though. That's what happened. I got a little minor heckled. But 18 minutes, bro. I was on stage for so long last Friday night. I was on stage for so long on Friday night that I actually, didn't know I had that much time. So I resorted to asking the audience,
what else is going on? Oh no, I said it. I broke my cardinal rule. I'm gonna pull my hair out. Tougher than Nigerian hair. A millionaire. I'm a young money millionaire. Tie this up. I'm gonna spin it up like this. I even resorted to taking my hat off on stage. I only took my hat off twice. Once because the audience was heckling, and second, the audience heckled. Whenever the audience heckled, I take my hat off. It really shakes the room up. Shake them dreads, shake them. Man, let me see you shake your green. Let me see you shake your green. Let me see you shake your green. In these face. I'm Max. Doors open, man. Goof ride the whip. Hip. Oh, Max. Look at my rims. They got hydraulics. Hip. I'm tripping. I'm also watching The Dark Knight right now. I just realized Pusha T really dedicated It's Almost Draft to Joker. He called himself Arthur Fleck. Like, he really... This is the Joker album. I'm calling it now. From now on, it's the Joker album. It's Almost Draft. It's Pusha T's Joker album. Yeah, he's speaking from the point of view of the Joker. Let the smoker shine the coos. You know what's something going on in my family today? Because it's Saturday and my parents are home. Y'all supposed to go out on Saturday and have fun. Something serious is going on. Y'all in the house. I'm supposed to be able to speak a little louder than this. Send me on the hotline. And I'm up having phone sex with ya. You know that I'm honey. And I'm up lusting for ya. As always, fuck all the gatekeepers. Fuck them. I found out about a cool club in Chicago. You sign up for the open mic. You get on the open mic and you perform your 5-minute sets. See how simple that is? No gatekeeping. God, I love Chicago. Never been, but I'm going soon. No gatekeeping. Just sign up and get on. It's a comedy club, but they want you to perform. They don't say, you don't have the demographic of jokes you want here. I'm not going to select you. Fuck off. I be forgetting this a whole wide world out there, and I ain't got to focus on the local comedy scene. I could do jokes in London. I'm in London, going shopping in the mall. Shopping the mall, shopping the store. Boom, 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 boom. Straight up. Cash in, cash out, cash in, cash out, cash in, cash out, cash in, cash out, cash out, cash out, cash out, cash out. Ooh. Riding in the curb with no thing. I want to make a list of all the black people that found out about Venmo and created a profile on the spot so they can get paid. Because I know I did it. I had all Cash Apps. So I said, you got Venmo? I said, I'll download it right now. Like, yeah, Cash App for black people. Venmo's for everyone else. I'm like, yeah, black people love Cash App. Because it's green. Green is the best color in the world. Venmo's not pretty. Cash App is pretty. Cash App is like green and white. Ooh, the dollar sign. Venmo's like, yeah, it's all white with some dark police blue. And you use an at symbol. No dollar sign. No cash sign. And it's like, ugh. Cash App's way cooler. They have more fun over there. Venmo's like, we're how you wire money and transfer funds to one another, and it's not that hard. It's pretty easy. It's not at all difficult. Punch in this code name, get your verification out of the way, and bloopity bloop 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 bloop. And then Cash App's just like, dollar sign, green. No, where the hoes at? You know what I'm saying? Oh no, I just dropped my hair on the ground. Oh, here it goes. Bad boy can't stop, won't stop. Woo.
I just want comedians to stop beefing with each other. We're supposed to be in the business of comedy. We should be nice to one another.
That's why I like Godfrey. He's neutral. He'll have Faison Love, Corey Holcomb, and Ari Spears on his show one by one. And the three of them might have differences with each other. Like, someone might not like Aries, someone might not like Corey, someone might not like Faison. But Godfrey's neutral. He's literally comedy Switzerland. That's why Godfrey is one of the most successful comedians in the world. This is facts, not just opinions. This is facts. Because Godfrey stays out of trouble, he keeps it real, he keeps it funny, which is most important.
A lot of places want you to be cool. You can't perform on this stage unless you're cool. You gotta be cool to get on this stage. You gotta be cool. I don't care if you've been doing comedy for 5 years. No, you can't get on the stage. You're not prestige enough. You're not cool. You don't wear cool shirts. You don't have enough followers. Who are you open for? You have any TV credits? But you're not cool. I don't care if you're funny. You gotta be cool to get on the stage. If you're not cool, earn my click. You're getting no stage time, see? Okay, you don't exist. How about that? You no longer exist in my world. I love the fact that you can cut people out of your life so easily. I cut relatives out. I cut non-relatives out. I cut people out. I cut pieces of media out. That movie doesn't exist in my mind. At all. That movie is invisible to me. I don't even know what it is. Clay Aiken. If I was invisible, you could see me in your vision. Last time I saw Clay Aiken, I think it was Eric Andre's show.
I forget my salsa. Whoa, 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 check out for my new single, it's called My Salsa. Whoa, whoa, salsa, 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 salsa. My salsa makes out the pretty girl want to dance and take off that underpants. My salsa makes out the pretty girl want to dance and take off that underpants. My salsa. Whoa, whoa,
hey. It's your chance. You're gonna be your man. Let me show. Bro, girl, girl, now you know you're my world. I now lose you. Oh, a Willow trailer. They got a Willow trailer. We up. Willow trailer this November. We're up. We up, baby. Where's Val Kilmer? He's sick. We up. Short King Winter. King Winter. It's going to be a short King Winter. Okay. Oh, no. We up. I gotta delete that. I got We Up. I just did post the trailer for Willow. I gotta post Short King. They keep saying Kong. That's racist. Winter. They don't want no black man to be a king, but they want to be the Kong. See what I mean? That's the con, man. We Up. Yeah, Disney's just posting all the trailers right now. Posting everything. Werewolf, they're doing a Jack Russell Werewolf by Night short that's coming out. I'm watching the video of this lady. She's shaking her butt. Oh god, I gotta unfollow this guy. This prop money, it's a girl with a fat butt. Yeah, I gotta unfollow you, dog. You can't be posting girls on the internet talking about, hey, look at this girl, she's hot, go follow her. No, she ain't giving up no cheeks, dummy. I'm not following a girl and getting no cheeks up. What kind of idiot does that? Says, hey everyone, follow this girl. Look at videos of her butt. Look how big her butt is. Can I hit? Shut up, stupid. Shut up, dummy. Modern day soap operas, you ain't popping. Oh god, I'm not watching that, man. No, I don't care about stupid. No. It's all dumb and no, I hate it all. I don't want to see any of this stuff. Hold on. Who's Kamzat Chimichanga? Hold on. Rewatch. You come to fuck everybody. Think it over now. Come to smash everybody. Come to fuck everybody. And that's the way that game goes. I got family in the next room being loud. You know how the melanated people are? They talk a lot, man. They out here. Be Corey.
What up, fam? We're gonna start at 1 o'clock, like I said. I was up all night in Chicago at that show, but
Corey voice horse.
Trying to be a G. Do what I say, say what I do. Y'all come on out here.
Corey Holcomb.
You can meet us while we walking.
Corey Holcomb.
I might fall out along the way.
Voice is hoarse.
Somebody might videotape that. I know it ain't that bad. It ain't that bad today. It's a nice day.
The weather's getting nice. Right. I like this time of the weather.
You got to do it.
Nice little fall weather.
It's not blazing hot. It's not freezing cold. Although, if we're going to talk about extreme weather, I am a huge fan of the freezing cold. And if you have a problem with black people and being in nerd culture and nerd media, fuck off and fuck you, you piece of shit. I can't wait to see the Blue Marvel movie. I can't wait to see Bumblebee from DC. I can't wait to see Icon from DC. I can't wait to see Spike in Marvel. I can't wait to see the new Blade movie. I can't wait to see probably Multiple Man on Secret Invasion. Hopefully he's a mutant. That would be cool. X-Men are coming. Yay! Multiple Man is going to be Kingsley Benadire. That's the gentleman that played Malcolm X in One Night in Miami. And he also is going to play Bob Marley. I think the Jamaicans are mad. That Kingsley Benadire, the British actor playing the Jamaican reggae icon, pioneer, godfather, king of guy. Well, a British guy played Martin Luther King in Selma, and I just didn't watch it. Same for the British woman who played Harriet Tubman, and I didn't watch that. I watched One Night in Miami because Sam Cooke was played by Leslie Odom Jr., who was American. And Jim Brown was played by Aldis Hodge, who was American. And that guy from Ballers, who looks like one of my cousins, played Malcolm X. He's also American. And the only British guy was the guy who played Malcolm X. So we got a 3-for-1. 3-on-1? I don't know. But y'all got Bob Marley. That's one guy. And y'all 1-on-1 is British. And we got our One Night in Miami, that's 3. And then you got Ray Charles, played by Jamie Foxx, American. Frankie Lyman, played by Lawrence Tate, American. Little Richard, played by Leon Robinson, American. Jimi Hendrix, played by Wood Harris, American. Also played by Andre 2000, American. So, hey, you got to get some Jamaican actors, buddy. The only Jamaican actor I know about is Bokeem Woodbine, man. Come on, man, you got to get some more Jamaican actors. You want a Jamaican to play Bob Marley, you gotta start casting like that. You gotta do some acting lessons. You gotta cast it, brother. The only Jamaican person I know, 50 Cent's kind of Jamaican. Viola Davis played his grandmother in Get Rich or Die Tryin'. And his grandfather was also Jamaican. And he lived in Queens, South Jamaica, Queens, where a lot of Jamaicans live. Hey, man, you gotta outsource. Look it up. Go to a comedy show. Look for some Jamaican comedians. Maybe they resemble Bob Marley. Comedians are always good actors every now and then. Sometimes, not always. Who knows?
There we go.
My teeth aren't that white right now, and I do apologize if they're unsightly. But also, I have a toothbrush, and I brush my teeth with coconut oil. So my teeth are going to be white in no time. I just got to keep going. Don't forget, stay hydrated, purchase a legal firearm, grow your own food, make sure you know how to physically defend yourself in a fight or altercation. Cobra Kai, strike first, strike hard, no mercy. Daniel LaRusso? Kenny called his son LaPuso. He was a fat fucker to play video games all day, then they recast him with a taller, skinnier feller, who's still a fucking nerd and a pussy. LaPuso? Better learn how to fight so they stop bothering you. I ain't gotta worry about fighting people. I'm worried about animals. I'm worried about snakes, turtles, turkey vultures, owls, squirrels, rats, horses, dogs, cats. I already said foxes, snakes, spiders, crickets and grasshoppers and mosquitoes. Mosquitoes and also crackheads. A lot of strange characters you meet when you're out and about. I call them freaks and geeks, or strangers and freaks. Like the Grand Theft Auto mission level, it's called Strangers and Freaks. This whole podcast is going to be whispering because I got company next door, and I don't need them hearing me talk about what I'm talking about, because I'm saying some very important things, if you haven't noticed. This is beginning to get more like an ASMR podcast, but make sure you got your headphones in both ears and you're not in a loud environment, because if you're in a loud environment, you can't hear a word that I'm saying, man. I should be charging up my phone right about now. I'm slipping. I'm falling. I can't get up. I always crack myself up. Here we go. Oh, celebrating 62 years of the Amazing Spider-Man comic book anniversary. 62 years. Golly gee willikers. Stan Lee has seen it all. He has seen a lot. You know who ain't seen nothing no more? The Queen of England. The Queen of England. I speak English. That's how I know how to say her name. She was mean, racist, old crazy lady. People saying she was on the reptilian side of the game, licking your eyeballs like a gecko lizard or something. Interesting. Very interesting. Don't know much about David Arnold, rest in peace. Corey Holcomb said he stole jokes, so I always avoided David Arnold's comedy. You know, man. Corey's probably going to get on 5150 on Tuesday night and say, me and Dave had our differences. Motherfucker was a thief. He wasn't a solid dude, no bogus motherfucker. But he is what he is, man. Rest in peace, man. Life is short. Do what you want to do, baby. Hullabaloo. Yo, the stash is coming in. The stash is coming in. The stash is coming in. Secret Invasion gives me Winter Soldier vibes. I'm glad they're back. Hopefully it's less CGI. Hey Marvel, ease up on the CGI. Moon Knight looks perfectly fine how he is. That costume is fit. He ain't gotta CGI it up. Let it be. Like the Beatles. Let it be. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Oh man. I've been eating right too. I did some low-key intermittent fasting. The importance of RRR. RRR. Why it's a big deal. You know what? I don't really need this bullshit right now. How do I get rid of this shit? Get out of my face. Get out of my face. Get out of my face. I keep getting these fucking dumbass, like the icons on the internet. They keep. Oh, here you go. Intermittent. Oh, it's intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting. 16 hours fast, 18 hours fed. So I eat like a crazy person for 8 hours straight, and for 16 hours I do nothing. Fuck off. Fuck off. No food for 16 hours? Who do you think you are? Am I gonna suffer from famine? Am I Irish? Is this the Great Potato Famine? Is this a hunger strike? Am I on a hunger strike or something? Is that what this is? Am I fucking protesting? Is that what you want me to do? Want me to fucking protest? You fucking mulakas. You fucking Yankee Doodle Dandle liberals. This is what I'm supposed to do? In order to lose weight and get in shape? As you can see, I only got one chin. I ain't no fat fuck. Alright? Moms don't flabble flabble. They fold. Alright? It is what it is, baby. It's 5 in the morning, and I'm having phone sex with ya. You know you want my loving, babe. You got me twisted over you. Another episode 80 of the Leroy Perry Cast. It's only 40 minutes.
And I feel like I'm tripping, cause I don't know what to do, and my career's gonna end real soon.
Leroy Fury Cast, every Monday, Leroy Fury Cast, LeroyFuriCast. I am Leroy Furious on all platforms, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, LeroyFurious. Cash App and Venmo, both Leroy Furious. Cash App, $LeroyFuriOus. Venmo is @ LeroyFuriOus. Yeah. And that's the way the Leroy Fury Cast episode 80 ends. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to this dick in your mouth. I am the brother in black. Forget all of my message.
Hold on. Look. I'm men in black. Look at this. I'm men in black. Hold on.
Alright, I'm out. I just flashed the light into the camera as if I were a men in black character. Agent L. They got Michael Jackson in Men in Black, bro. I could be Agent M. How you get Michael Jackson in a movie? That's crazy. Michael Jackson, Nick Cannon, and Rosario Dawson in one movie. So many name drops. Leroy Fury Cast, episode 80. I'm out this bitch. Peace.
This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious. The Leroy Fury Cast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my. I say what the fuck I want, bitch.